It is time to meet our musical guest tonight. He's a member of the biggest boy band in the world, and now he's broken records with the release of his first solo single, This Town. Please welcome Niall Horan. There he is. Oh, look at that. Lovely. Nice. Now, here's the thing. I would introduce you, but I think you've met Amy before.
Yes. Yeah. Myself and Amy did, she did it and we were there. SNL, Saturday Night Live in New York.
Oh, yes.
She was the host of it. We were there. There we are.
You were very sweet. You got to hold my feet. I don't know how fortunate that was. Yeah. But your band member on the other end, Zane, forgive me if I get it wrong, he was quivering because my upper body apparently was too heavy for him.
Wow.
I highly doubt that.
Yeah, he really was by the end because we took so many takes. You know, I think that was a bit heavy for him. I think he's used to lighter girls.
Now, the last One Direction concert, that was about a year ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, around the same.
By my reckoning, that's kind of a year off.
Yeah.
So that's a lot of Judge Rinder. What are you what are you doing?
I'm definitely not watching Judge Rinder anyway. At the start of the year, the plan was to go backpacking.
Lovely.
So I did it. So me and two of my cousins one of my cousins was living in Melbourne in Australia, and he was actually moving back home. So we just said, right, we'll meet in Australia and then we'll work our way back across. So we went up through, went to Bali first, pissed rain for 4 days, no good. nearly got my wallet robbed by a monkey, so that wasn't great. Then went up to Philippines, did a couple of islands in the Philippines, went across to Vietnam, Cambodia, did all the temples and stuff.
It sounds amazing. But now, is this the trip where you had a very strict budget?
Yeah, well, yeah. We just wanted to do it properly because, all my friends got to do it, but I was traveling the world in a different way.
Yeah.
So I just thought, it's only fair I get to do it.
So you were staying in youth hostels and things?
Yeah.
Now, were you not cousins really
pissed
off?
Not really hostels, you'd be surprised.
Your cousins must be thinking, he's a multi-millionaire, and I'm sleeping in a bunk.
Yeah, they probably were, but they would never say it to me. we just thought, it wasn't really, really hostels. We went to the hostels when we were going drinking, because they're always good crack.
Oh, right.
But, you'd be surprised what 20 quid gets you.
I don't want to know. Mind you, it's good you were travelling when you did.
Yeah. That's pretty cool, though. I mean, fair play. Putting a budget on yourself when you're a thing. That's pretty good.
But did you not break it sometimes? Did you not kind of think...
Oh, yeah, after about a month, we got to Hanoi in Vietnam.
And you bought the city. I own Hanoi now. Yeah. I cracked. I just love the place. I just loved it.
We were just like, come on, we'll just get a hotel. A nice one this time.
Okay, so you own a hotel in Hanoi.
Yeah.
Okay.
a couple of them.
It's like Monopoly. Yeah. The Hanoi board. And because obviously when it ends, when you go on the break, it must be lovely. You just go, oh, thank God for that. But have you started to miss the others yet? Is it weird now being back in music without them?
Yeah, of course. You know, I suppose until recently, I haven't kind of noticed as much in the sense as I've just been in the studio. And we always kind of, when we were writing, we'd always go off into different groups and kind of, do our own kind of writing and then bring it all back to when everyone was recording. But recently I've kind of noticed that, okay, this is it now. I have this song, I'm writing an album for me, and I'm probably going to tour it on my own. So, this is my first performance, this one here. So,
good on you, brother. Yeah. We're looking forward to it. And, do you get back to Ireland much? Do you cause a huge sensation when you go back? Is it Mullingar?
Yeah, Mullingar, yeah.
Yeah.
I go home a couple of times a year. It gets, my dad still lives in the same spot. So it gets kind of hectic around the house.
Do girls live in holes in the garden and things?
Yeah, I remember, under the wall. I remember Robbie Williams once said something to me. He was like, My mum closed the curtains in 92 and never opened them again. I get it. So, yeah, but, yeah, like, it's good. I get to go home and, you know, go see the lads and stuff like that and see the family, and it's, yeah, I like that side of it. But, yeah, it's Miss Ireland. Obviously, yeah. We'd like to go there a lot more, but...
And do people kind of... Do they look out for you kind of going, oh, he's changed, or is it all that? Do you have to be incredibly careful when you go home?
Sometimes, like, you'd be in there and you'd be, like, as there's kind of, like, the backpacking thing there. You'd be buying, like, a pint, you know, be buying a pint for... two or three of the lads, and then, you know, the barman would be going, oh, someone's doing all right, and he's doing good. It's like, it's only a few pints. I don't know if it's, it makes any difference. But, yeah, like, sometimes if I'm walking home, right, I'll walk home if they're just, if I'm home around Christmas and there's no taxis, and I'll start walking home, and then the police will walk, drive past me and pick me up and bring me home. I remember when they used to do that for a different reason. Yeah, they do that. Which is quite funny.
Because they catch you out when you go home, don't they, Chris?
Well, I mean, there is, like Niall said, there's this odd thing where people want to catch you out a little bit. Mm. Like, you'll go even for breakfast somewhere or for lunch. And I remember I was actually home this weekend and I was, we went out for, you know, some eggs and stuff somewhere. And I was like, oh, yeah, you know, and I'll have some orange juice. And they're like, oh. Oh, Mr. L.A. with his orange juice. And it's regardless of what, like, it doesn't need to be anything fancy. It's like, oh, yeah, I'll have, like, you know, an Americano or it's, oh. Like, before I left, I used to just bathe in my own shit. There's this kind of overcompensation. There is a little bit of that, but, like, it's inundated with the kind of the other side of it, which is really kind of lovely, right? Yeah.
And Amy Adams, I think because of the red hair, people assume you must... some Irish.
Yeah, I think I've got some Irish blood in me. Yeah.
Because I must say, we found this picture.
I can vouch for that.
Wow! It was going so well.
But you know what? What's weird about it? It's not even like I have Irish in me. It sounds like I gave her like a blood transfusion. And I actually am a blood donor. So.
You never know. But no, we found a picture of you, and rarely has a woman looked more Irish than Amy. Look at that.
It's such a flattering picture. There you go.
Is that in your caravan?
Three sisters. That's my three sisters right there.
There it is, folks. Yeah, that's such an flattering picture.
It's not there. Stop looking at it, it'll go away. Now, Niall, talking about it, so the new single, This Town, This Is You, it's a song, is it about Mullingar, or...?
Sort of, yeah. It's kind of, like, got a double meaning. It's not really about anyone in particular. I just kind of, when I'm writing songs, I write the concepts and then just kind of write a scenario and then write the song around it. But I guess with the town part of it, I guess it's kind of a little bit like everything, you know, there's a line in the song, everything comes back to you. You know, and I still go home all the time, and, you know, no matter how far you've travelled, you still get to go home and be yourself. And then it's obviously got that female aspect
of it
too.
Now, every girl in Mullingar must be thinking, he's talking about me.
I had loads of texts saying, like, from people, like, from school saying, everyone wants to know who it's about. It's not about anyone. So, I'm clearing it up on national television.
Well, your first performance awaits. The guitar is over there. If you want to go over and get ready. Not hard, everybody. All right, here with his first ever TV performance of This Town, it is Mr. Niall Horan.
Waking up to kiss you and nobody's there. The smell of your perfume still stuck in the air. It's hard. Yesterday I thought I saw your shadow running around. It's funny how things never change in this old town. So far from the stars. tell you everything. Words I never got to say the first time around. And I remember everything from when we were the children playing in this fairground. Wish I was there with you now. As if the whole world was watching, I'd still dance with you. Drive highways and byways to be there with you. Over and over, the only truth, everything comes back to you. Mm-hmm. I saw that you moved on with someone new. In the pub there we met, he's got his arms around you. It's so hard. Tell you everything, words I never got to see the first time around. And I remember everything from when we were the children playing in this fairground. Wish I was there with you now. As if the whole world was watching, I'd still dance with you. Drive highways and byways to be there with you. Over and over, the only truth, everything comes back to you. You still make me nervous when you walk in the room. Them butterflies, they come alive when I'm next to you. Over and over, the only truth, everything comes back to you. Wrong, that I can't move on, but there's something about you. Cause if the whole world was watching, I'd still dance with you. Drive highways and byways to be there with you. Over and over, the only truth, everything comes back to you. You still make me nervous when you walk in the room. Butterflies, they come alive when I'm next to you. Over and over, the only truth, everything comes back to you. Mm-hmm. Everything comes back to you.
Gorgeous.
Thank you, my love.
Oh, that was fantastic, Niall. And so that single's out now. Album?
Yeah, kind of. That was like the first song that was completely finished and I felt was good enough to kind of let people know that I was doing something. But I'm kind of now just about to start the recording process and the recording all the instruments and all that kind of stuff right now. All the songs are written, but I just need to get all recorded.
My God, you're so pretty in person.
Same with you.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Good for you.
Thank you.
And Niall Horan, I have a vision of all those girls, the One Direction fans, they're sitting at home like Miss Havisham in One Direction t-shirts, waiting and waiting. Will you ever tell them to give up? Will, you know, like, what's happening? Will they wait for the rest of their lives? Will they wait as long as Bross for you to come back?
As long as Bross. Oh, no. Like, for now, in the moment, we're kind of doing our own thing. I'm doing this. You know, Harry's doing a movie. Harry did a movie. You know, we're all kind of doing our own bits and pieces. And then can't really put a date on it, but, you know, it's not going to be 50 years away. Like, it's in the foreseeable.
How many years?
I don't know, Chris. We don't know. And when right. I do, I'll text you.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you so much for doing that. It was beautiful. Niall Horan, everybody. Okay. Nearly it. But before we go, by popular demand, it is back. Let's have a story from the big red chair. Hello.
Hello, Graham.
Hi. What's your name?
Justin.
Justin. And where are you from?
I'm originally from Aussie, Australia, but now live in Clapham.
Okay.
You're the only Aussie in Clapham.
The rest of them are Irish.
Yeah. And what do you do?
I design bicycle parking and change room facilities for office buildings. Mm. Bit random.
I'm so tempted.
That's useful.
No, imagine if you were sitting at a dinner party and Justin told you that. Your heart would sink. You'd just think,
he's saying,
Jesus.
He's saying it's a good one.
Yeah.
He said it's a good one.
Okay. Off you go with the story, Justin.
All right, so the other day, it's a couple of weeks ago, I had a hangover, big hangover, and I decided to just dust it off with a run through the local commons of Clapham.
Oh, yes.
Anyway, I got halfway through and I had uncontrollable stomach cramps. And without a toilet in sight, I thought, no, there's a bit of density over there. I'm going to head in there and do my business. So anyway, I'm there and I'm just finishing up. And next thing I see this movement right. And there's a lady walking along with her two dogs and they're off the leash. Anyway, one of them starts, I pull up my pants, and next thing this pit bull starts coming towards me.
No, I can't listen to the end of this story.
How did it go that long? She's just like pooping in the woods of the dog.
As a dog owner, I know what happened next.
Yeah. I lost track a little bit, and then I kind of tuned back in. I was like, oh, he's shitting in the park.
Yeah. They come over here, they shit in our parks.
He didn't have any toilet paper. That's all I kept thinking is, I'm sure he didn't bring toilet paper to the park.
No.
I don't think that's the biggest problem.
Can I get my 3 minutes back in my life? Because this is...
I think the pit bull probably solved that problem. Should we try one more?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, okay. Here we go. This is the one. This is the charm. Hello. They love you. What's your name?
My name's Sean.
Sean. Lovely. Where are you from?
I'm from Donegal.
He's from Donegal. Hey. He's from Donegal. Marvellous. And do you live here or there?
Yeah, I live in London now.
Oh, right. What do you do, Sean?
I work in sales. So.
Yeah. I know. Pays the bills. Okay. Off you go with the story, Sean.
So a few years ago, I was at a wedding, and the ceremony happened. It was lovely. And then we went to the reception. And at the reception, everybody started doing speeches. And then the groom stood up and said to everyone, we're going to play a game. So he said, asked everyone to stand up. So everyone stood up. Everybody was kind of giggling. And then he asked everyone to flip over their plate. And if there's a red dot at the bottom of their plate, please stay standing. So everyone did it, and it kind of filtered out. And then there was 8 guys left standing. And he said, ladies and gentlemen, can you all please look at the 8 gentlemen left standing? They have slept with my wife since we've been engaged. I am now going for an annulment. And he walked straight out of the room.
Good one! Love that story. Well done, Sean. You can walk. Okay. And if you'd like to join us on the show, and have a go in that red chair, you can contact us via website at this very address. That is it for tonight. Please say a big thank you to my guests, Niall Horan. With music from the mighty Kings of Leon, the hilarious Catherine Tate, the brilliant Jude Law, the beautiful Colby Smulders, and the Hollywood legend that is Mr. Tom Cruise. I'll see you then. Good night, everybody. Bye-bye.